see what we need in the holy sacrament of marriage. As you know, I am not a trauma priest, I am a sound priest. So our service today will be contacted in English language, so everyone will be understand. And I'm sure the Holy Spirit will inspire you to understand the different languages. Now I invite you all to join with me this holy mass in prayer. Please rise up.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, prepare ourselves to celebrate these mysteries. Let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Virgin Mary, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Yeah. que la va a escoger. Aplicar que te haga el pan, o quitar la no ama que te haga. Con ojo, o que le haga un poco, como a la ley. Con ojo, o quitar que le mejeta. O quitar que le falte que lo mojó. O quitar que le falte un poco al ave. O quitar que le falte al tao. O quitar que le cumbre en esta batalla.
Some Pharisees approached Jesus, and to test him, they said, "It is against the law for a man to divorce his wife on any reason." Jesus answered, "Have you not read what the Creator from the very beginning? That is why a man left his family, his parents, and joined to his wife, and they are no longer one, a two, but one. Therefore, no divided body, but they have become one body in God. But God has divided, man must not divide." The Gospel of the Lord. Love is the basis of a good marriage. Love is the basis of a good marriage. The fee of the devil of Timothy and Hosea. Timothy and Hosea, the sacrament of marriage is a celebration in front of God and all of us here today. You see how many people are here today for you. So it's a serious sacrament. The union of two people who are declaring their love for each other. We know that in our daily life there are hard times that can challenge this love. Yesterday I celebrated my love to God in the sacrament of order to be a priest. Last week, 27 years of my priesthood, and I'm still happy as a priest. God is my promise to God. And today, two of you celebrate another sacrament. The union with God, with one another, and you have become one body. One love and one spirit. And that's why sometimes hard time challenges that love. But a marriage that is based on God's love and values and teaching can withstand any temptation and come out intact. This would be a marriage that exists and practices the values of love. So what is love? This is loving God and other people more than we love ourselves sometimes. In doing this, your love is reflected back to you with nurturing and compassion in many ways. Loving each other is a vital requirement in marriage. So put love in your heart every time and you will be a happy marriage. What is another good value of marriage? What about respect? Many couples these days, they never respect each other. They do whatever they want. But respect is about showing respect when relating to one another. Respect is earned through the way you show your respect to your spouse. And it's vital in achieving a harmonious relationship. Respect also constitutes a love and humility and self-respect. Don't forget, you need to respect each other. Remember our preparation before marriage, and he was very happy in our video preparation. Formation of marriage is like a formation to the priesthood. If you are not prepared, you are not happy. What is another good value of marriage? What about humility? Some marriages, I never have of sometimes. They all want to go up. And it's why marriage destroys. Because there's no humility. So humility, Timothy and Alcida, and humbleness are leadership qualities. It is important to incorporate this in your interaction with each other. in order to maintain equality in your own relationship. Remember, when your preparation, I told you, many friends, less friends is better. Your best friend is your wife or your husband. Whatever happened, discuss between you. Don't discuss with your friends, because it's hard sometimes. So first, you discuss between you two. Whatever happened, hard time or easy time, you discuss with you. And keep for yourself. What is another good value of marriage? Instead of you go to what I said. If you don't know what is another good value of marriage, another good value of marriage is dignity. What about the dignity of a person? By maintaining your own dignity as an individual, you are therefore able to uphold the dignity of your partner or your wife or your husband and other people in your lives. One day you have children. Your children want to see the parents happy and have the dignity. What is another value of marriage? What about the unity? Keeping your marriage intact and happy requires both of you to be strong in your commitment to be united. Many marriages are divorced and separated because there is no unity. The wife wants to do what she wants and the husband wants to do what she wants again. Bye, 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 bye. And that's not a good marriage. Needs the unity of marriage. If you are united, you are a strong marriage. If you are not united, you will be feel isolated. Remember this word. If you are not united, you will feel isolated and weak. Unity is also about communication. Remember we talked about communication. There are marriages that have communicated many times. But communication is the center of marriage. It is crucial sometimes in successful marriage. So share yourself. Share between you. Other people mind their own business. It's about you too. Because there are people they want to enter to your business. Forget about. So, unity is very important in the life of marriage. What is another value of marriage? It's better also for other marriages. They are just like these days. Another important value of marriage is about honesty. We talk about that in our formation. Honesty. If honesty is not part of your marriage life, there will be no trust, you see? If there is no honesty, there is no trust in your marriage. So you need to be honest. Whatever small or big things, you need to be honest. Otherwise, what is the value of marriage? Honesty will see both of you in tune with each other's needs. Oh, I want to enjoy myself, so I'm going to enjoy myself. What about our marriage? Integrity. You must have faith in God, first of all, to guide and calm your nerves in every way. Before, remember I told you, go to the church. It means you love God and you have faith in God. And good also for other marriages here. They are now 50% or 40% are not going to the church. If you are not going to the church, please go to the church. It's very important. So, you must have faith in God to guide you and to guide you in every way. And if our faith, my dear friend, in God, we are not here today. Your faith in God will strengthen your faith in each other's ability to honor your married spouse. Another 2 or 3 minutes, you will promise that house, and that's what marriage, well, that's what faith is. Your faith in God will strengthen your faith in each other's ability to honor your marriage vows. Not far away, you exchange your vows. Remember, when you say, I don't want to hear one day, you are not I do anymore. It's God. So you are true today, it's not like you to God's power, you are true to God. Remember? And I don't want to hear that, because after today, you are going by yourself. And I don't want to hear tomorrow, your I true is lost. I do nothing. That is what that is. With total responsibility. You are responsible for your marriage. Remember I told you when formation you prepare, if you have a problem back here, your spiritual father is here. If you are not finding me, you find your parents, especially your mothers. Your mothers are the best mentor ever in the world. So if you are not finding me as a spiritual father, your parents are there for you. Not your friends. Forget about friends sometimes. Because it's lost sometimes. But your face in the door is God. If you are not finding God, find me. I'm always there for you. And your parents are there for you too. One of the fundamental factors that be a total happy marriage is the necessity to maintain a union with Christ in the sacrament of the Holy Communion today. Not only married to God, but we receive also the Holy Communion. Remember that. You receive Christ in your heart. The center of our faith to God is the Eucharist. So that's one of the fundamental facts of today. You need to be happy because you see Christ in your heart. How wonderful if you understand what I'm talking about. Attending to the Mass every Sunday is a wonderful thing. You work from Monday to Saturday, but yes, go to the Mass on Sunday, not only to hear the words of God, but also to receive the sacrament of the Eucharist, the center of our faith. It's well enough to keep your faith in God alive every day and love each other with prosper within your marriage. So I want to finish here, but before I finish, my final words to you, my spiritual children, because you are my spiritual children and you know I love you so much. So this is my final words I want to put in your heart. Wherever you go, remember this word. Keep up your grace, first. Be patient always, because sometimes they have no patience. Patience is the key word for the marriage. So be patient every day. Don't lose your patience. Live happily in according with your calling through marriage. Don't forget, it's a sacrament.
So live happy in accordance with your marriage. May Jesus Christ be your shield, the Holy Spirit be your guide every day, Mary our mother, your shining star. Mary is there, your shining star for you every day. Don't forget this year, this year of marriage. So if you need help, go and pray to Mary. You love your mother, because that is where you come from the world. You need to love Mary. And God be your strength every time. And that's why I advise you to go to the church every Sunday. You need a blessing from God. That's all I want to say. Because today, you are called to your own way. And I miss you. My love, I miss you so much. I'm sure we all miss you. And that's why we are here today. And we all love you.
My dear friends, you have come together this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the faith minister and this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already instructed you in the baptism and now enriched you in the sacrament of marriage. I ask you now to state your intention. Timothy and Halcyon, have you come here freely without reservation to give yourself to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as a man and wife for the rest of your life? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, now join your right hands and declare your consent before God, before me and His church. I, Timothy, take you, Halcyon, to be my lawful wife.
To be my lawful wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true.
In good times, in bad times.
In good times, in bad times.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Halcyon.
I, Halcyon.
I take you, Timothy.
I take you, Timothy.
To be my lawful husband.
My
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and bad times.
In good times and in bad times.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You have declared your consent before me and before the church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both in His blessing. What God has joined me must not divide. Now I ask the rings, please bring the rings forward. Did the Lord bless his ring? Which you give to each other as a sign of your love and charity. Lord, bless these rings which we have given. Grant that those who wear them may always have keep faith in each other. May they do your will and always live together in peace, good, and love. We ask this, grant.
I'll see you.
Take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Timothy,
take this ring
as a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love
and fidelity. In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Now, today you are called husband and wife, and now you may kiss your wife. Put together our hands. To let you know, it's very important, these candles. Remember when they are carrying their baby in the womb, and when they have a baby, come out and see the light of God. And this candle is the light of Christ. So now they share this light of Christ to their children today. And this light is still burning until the end of time. So now I invite the mothers to bring the candle to their children. The expressions of love from the mother to the child. Thank you so much. Talk about that and this response also from
ke monu ia pe ara ka ka monu a ke a kore a ko ha ko fonga ka ko mato ka mato ta ko Francis ko tu ta ko pe ke manu ia me ko ni ko que os que
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your mighty Father. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be shared for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Of salvation.
giving thanks that you have had us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be together in the unity of the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis, all the ministry of your church, and your faithful people. Lord, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy and life. Welcome them into the light of your face. Lord our God, remember and bless Timothy and his wife, Lucia. Bless also their parents, families, and friends. They are coming far away from Australia, from Tonga, and all part of New Zealand. I ask your blessing to our Tonga choir, Catholic, who are here with us today, all the sick people, especially those who are in need. And bless us, O Lord, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be able to go as eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Glory and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called in the supper of the Lamb.